Hi everyone. So I am the last speaker, so I can understand. The quick I finish the, you can leave this room. So I'll keep it more crisp as possible. So today we'll be discussing on open source component. It's not very much technical in sense, like we just in the morning we learned about blockchain and no scan vulnerabilities and all. So it's just for the developers or the end user who are using or you are opening a site, and it's the very first step in a hacker's career to understand and frame his or her script. So to begin with, so this will be the outline, just three topics, nothing more. So the first we'll learn about what is the component with known vulnerabilities, then who all are the key players, and the last would be how to detect them, how early detection can be useful for you, and so on. So I'll skip my introduction part because they have already given. So the very first question arises, what is a component? So for you, the component would be a single piece of reusable code, or you can call it as open or paid, or developed by some other developers. Is it so? Is it this three or it's something more? Actually, it is much more than that. To give you certain facts and figures, Python has about 42,000 plus packages. Microsoft.NET has about 60,000 plus packages, and Ruby has about 50 million packages. So as a developer, when you are developing a code, you will directly use those packages and your work is done, right? So think of it is that what it is also bringing by saving your time, what you are also providing to the end user. You are also giving them a backdoor also. So this component can also create a small, help a hacker for a small hack to a RC also, remote code execution even. Recently there were hack in a, I'll not name the airline, but it was their biggest hack which happened just because they're using a very old version of a jQuery, which resulted in an RC and the database was out in the open. So these two figures are nothing much, but the first one is a simple Java code or a Java. If you have worked on Java and in order to code or in order to use some functions, you use several jars, right? So where do you get it? You build it in Maven or anything else, you just import packages, right? You don't know what this holds, you just use the function and your work is done. So you should also, so that first figure is just to tell you that 80% is the open source and 20% is your business logic what you write. So okay, you are serious about cyber security and all, you protect the 20%. So what about the 80%? And the next figure is about several open source, like you use Apache libraries, or in fact in Java also several jars, and in Python packages also. So have you looked upon and searched that if I'm using a package, what vulnerability it holds? I guess we are just in a hurry to deliver to a customer, we write the code and we push to the production. So the next question, next thing is about who are the key players. By key player, I doesn't mean that they are getting affected by it. The more is who uses it and who can protect it. The first is the component code developer. So I am using a package of certain libraries. So that like whoever is posting that packages to, or forking that package to the library to the site. Like from Git, I am using a open component, okay, and then I'm writing certain codes and my work is done. So the responsibility is with me also. I should be checking it by, there are several tools available in the market, I'll just show you in the next slide. Apart from that, we should also see, so the first responsibility is for the component code developer. They should also constantly upgrade the packages with the security, perfect security packages. And it's the responsibility of the programmer who runs the second point of the key player. They should also keep their code upgrading and also updating so that the latest security patches are with them. And the third and the final part is the end user. I guess the end user is nothing but whatever the hacks or whatever happens, it happens to the end user. But the major part plays with the sysadmin. So when we write a code and we push it to production environment, we can't, in a organization level, a developer can't directly push to the production environment, right? So it should go through certain process and procedures. So the sysadmin should also verify whatever the code is committed. Is this code correct? Is the packages involved in are correct or not? So this is much more into DevSecOps. So we'll not discuss on that. So our focus would be point number two. So in the morning, if you could have seen, Mr. Nath was giving some demo, right? He used one of this Wappalyser extension, and there he showed us that WordPress versions and etc. So think of it as you are a developer and you are developing your code. Before pushing it to staging environment or production environment, you are running your code and you can see these are your components, okay? So what does this help? Does it help to you? You will just know that, okay, I have written something in WordPress, what extra it can do? So we'll just take a pause here. The second part is, there is an NVD database, National Vulnerability Database. What it does that, whatever the open source components are there in the market, the related vulnerabilities, so there is a community who posts the vulnerabilities there. So what we have done is, we have extended this extension and added the NVD to this site. So the first picture is a demo test where it's the very first baby step towards ethical hacking. You can do all your attacks there. It's being developed by IBM, developed and maintained. So what you have done is, so the first picture says it was developed in ASP.NET and these are the server exposure and etc. So if we will select all these boxes and check combo, it will take you to NVD database site. Okay, and there it will show you what are the vulnerabilities are currently present in your right coded application. So what does it helps you? It saves your time. Okay, and it also, before you push it to production, you have a secure code. So I guess the times is up. So we'll not wait for any questions. Thank you.